nothing better than that first sip of coffee in the morning. I've got a little bit of foam on my lip, but good morning, Mon Petit, and welcome back to Vlogmas day 7. We are officially a week in to Vlogmas, and in the same respect, I can't believe we're already 7 days in. Like, I can't believe we're already a third of the way through Vlogmas, which is absolutely mind-blowing. But at the same time, I feel like I've been daily vlogging for like a month. At this point, I feel like we've done so much. Like, I mean it in a good way. We've had so many fun days, lots of festive activities, and lots more to come, which I am so, so looking forward to. But whilst I'm currently enjoying my morning coffee, I'm not gonna lie, I'm really, really enjoying my hazelnut lattes at the moment. I feel like they are just the perfect amount of festive without being like too sweet or like too festive, if that makes sense. Normally I'm a gingerbread gal through and through, and I've actually not been really reaching for the gingerbread lattes. This year I had my caramel waffle from Starbucks the other day, and then at home I'm using my hazelnut syrup and I'm really, really enjoying it. I'm not going to lie. And whilst I'm having my morning coffee, I'm gonna be a little bit naughty because Alex came home with a little gift for me last night. These are from Greggs. They are the, you'll love this, I think they are the Yum Yums. So they're kind of like a donutty type thing. Very naughty treat to have at 9 o'clock in the morning. I can't even pretend that this is like 11, sis, because it is first thing in the morning and this is basically going to be my breakfast, which is awful, but it's Christmas. I feel like that's gonna be my excuse for anything at this time of year. You want a pudding? It's Christmas. Do you want a second cup of coffee in the morning? It's Christmas. Do you wanna have a donut for your breakfast? It's Christmas. And Alex and I's love language, I swear, gift giving is such a huge one for the both of us. It's something that I always find really interesting, and I always say to couples to do your love language test because I feel like it's so helpful to understand how the other person feels love, but also how they like show love. So for both Alex and I, gift giving is huge, but like in the way that we show love. Like, I don't think either of us ever really like expect gifts, and I feel like gifts is one that's very, it's very misunderstood, because when you say that gift giving is your love language, people think you're very shallow. But even just like coming home, having passed to Greg's and gone, I'm gonna pick up Ellie a little donut, a little yum yum for her breakfast, or I'll just pick him up some chocolate on the way home, or I'll bake him brownies. Like, that to me is very much like the gift giving kind of love language that we have. But I would love to know what your love language is. Comment down below, because I find it so, so interesting. For me, it's all about acts of service. I just feel so loved when like people like think of me and like do things for me. Like, it was so funny actually the other day, I was in charge of defrosting dinner for the evening, and I don't have the best memory. I forgot to do it, and actually have forgotten to do it multiple times, not going to lie. And before leaving for work, Alex came into the kitchen and I saw him going into the freezer, and I was like, what are you doing going into the freezer? And he went, I'm gonna get dinner out for tonight because I know you'll probably forget, so I just don't want to put that on you. So I took the mental load and figured that I would take it out for dinner, and I just looked at him and was like, nothing could make me love you more. And it was funny because he turned around and said, oh, I thought you were gonna get annoyed at that, that I'm like assuming you're gonna kind of screw up. And I was like, but let's be honest, I was gonna forget, and I love that you know that about me. So I love that you've like had the foresight to do it for me and take it off my plate. So like lifts, if ever he like picks me up from the station, oh, that just makes my heart melt. If ever he just like does something for me, that is my love language. Whereas his is physical touch slash quality time. Those are the most important ones for him. So I could literally bake him brownies, and as lovely as that is for him, if I don't like give him a cuddle on the sofa at the end of the evening, doesn't feel loved, which I always find so interesting. So yes, let me know what your love language or your partner's love language is, because I just think it's so interesting to know. It just really helps you like understand each other better, helps you like show your love for each other better. And let's be honest, it's Christmas. It's all about the season of love. So I am gonna enjoy my coffee. I'm gonna enjoy my very naughty donut for my breakfast. And then we can head upstairs because I have some exciting things to show you. So I of course have not forgotten, I need to show you my Bista buys, the pieces I picked up after our gorgeous girl shopping trip yesterday. But I also have something rather exciting in my hand that has just arrived this morning, a new bag we need to unbox together. So let me show you the bits. I am so excited right now. So if you missed yesterday's vlog, then you may not have seen the Bista trip that I did with two of my best girlfriends, Emily and Meg. Which I would say, before watching this video, go back and watch that, because oh my god, it was such a fun day. We had so much fun at Bicester. I do have to be quite careful when I'm vlogging at Bicester, because certain stores don't let you vlog. They're very particular about allowing like cameras and allowing phones. It's very odd because they seem to allow FaceTimes. They're always okay with that. They don't like seeing you like with a camera or with like your phone going around the store. So I wasn't able to vlog in every single store that we went into, but we just had such a fun trip. I feel like the stock that they've got at Bicester at the moment is just absolutely incredible. So many gorgeous new bits for Christmas, for like Christmas gifting to treat yourself to. So where should we start? I think I'm gonna start with Ralphie, because you did actually see me trying these both on in store, and this is what is the best and the worst thing about going shopping with girlfriends, is that we're all each other's hype girls and we're all giving it, yes, get both colors. If you like it, just get it in another color. You deserve it. You've worked hard for it. You know you're gonna wear it. I am honestly the worst for it, but Em and Meg are both just as bad as I am. So we had a little trial session in Ralphie. Both Emily and I ended up getting a couple of knit jumpers, and I adore my Ralphie jumpers. I feel like they are just the most timeless, the most classic. I wear them all the time, but I was really wanting to replace one of them in my collection. I have an extra large in my black Ralph Lauren jumper, and I don't really know why I decided to buy an extra large. I think it was one of the few sizes that was left in stock. I remember I didn't really try it on at the time, and I was like, oversized fit will look cute. We'll just go for that kind of like boyfriend jumper look. And to tell you the honest truth, I never wear it. I feel like my style has definitely changed a lot over the last couple of years as well. And I've really steered away from those kind of like oversized, like loose, really like boyfriend fit knit. I feel like it's because of how petite I am. I much prefer something that's like a little bit more fitted. That's like, I mean, this jumper I'm wearing now, it's still quite loose. It's a gorgeous little ASOS number one with the beautiful pearl detailing on the necklace, which by the way, of course I had to do matching pearls in my earrings. These are, I think, Jennifer Bear, if I remember correctly, but you've got like the diamantes and the pearls, and then the diamantes and the pearls, because there's nothing I love more than a matchy matchy moment. So I do like a kind of like loose, cozy, comfy knit, but I feel like the oversized fit I am just so against now. So I wanted to basically replace that one that I had in my collection. So I wanted a black Ralphie jumper, which I feel like is so timeless. It's so classic. It goes with absolutely everything. And these are the kind of knits that I feel like you can dress them up or you can dress them down. If you want a more casual fit, what I would do is just wear like a little tee underneath, or even like a vest. I've got another vest on today, which I honestly could not live without. These are the little vests that I picked up from Miss Selfridge, and the white one is perfect to wear underneath my Ralphie jumpers, so that you just have that little kind of pop of collar. I feel like it really casuals it down. You could add something like a headband, like I was wearing yesterday, tie your hair up, wear it with jeans, wear it with trainers. It's very casual. However, if you wanted to elevate them a little bit, wear it without the t-shirt underneath, a slip skirt, pair of heel boots, and you've got a gorgeous, very elevated outfit. I wouldn't necessarily call it like an evening outfit, but let's say you're going for like a posh Sunday pub roast, or you're going for lunch for like the work Christmas party, but it's like during the daytime. I feel like it's such a lovely like elevated daytime look. So I love the black one. I feel like it doesn't get much more classic than this. So I picked it up in a medium, and it was 169 reduced to 117, which I feel like is a really, really good saving, especially considering number one, how much I wear these knit jumpers. Like, I know I'm gonna get my cost per wear out of them. And number two, considering that they don't date, they don't go out of style. Like, it kind of surprises me that Ralphie even reduces these in price anyway, because you can still find these for full price on the website, on loads of different retailers. So it's great to be able to pick it up at a discount. I then also picked it up in the gorgeous Merlot color. Now, this is a color that is quite interesting, because I feel like my camera really likes the color red. Whenever there is something like quite warm, like a brown or a red or even a green, weirdly, really distorts the color. So on camera, it is coming up a lot brighter. It's coming up more of like a raspberry color, whereas I would say this is much more deep and rich, more of a Merlot wine color, like a really expensive red wine, basically, which I absolutely adore. Number one, because we all know it is the color of the season. Burgundy is everywhere at the moment, and I am loving burgundy. I feel like it styles up really well with lots of different colorways. One of my favorite colorways to style it up with is black, but I also love styling it up with white or cream. I feel like Merlot and cream It is just so beautiful. And I'm thinking this could be really cute for a Christmas Day outfit. It is the time we need to start thinking about what we're gonna be wearing on Christmas Day. And a cute little Ralphie jumper with a slip skirt that has an elasticated waistband. It's a very, very cute Christmas Day outfit. So I went out to ask the girls because the lighting in the changing room was so, so bad. I was really unsure about it. And I wasn't sure if it kind of like worked with my skin tone. I was obviously wearing my vest. My vest was kind of poking out underneath. So I went and asked the girls at their opinion, and they were both gave me a resounding yes that I needed this jumper in my life. And I'm so glad that they convinced me to get it, because again, it was £169 reduced to £117, which I just think is such a good saving. I must admit, I feel like the Ralphie at Bicester is one of the best Ralph Lauren stores. They have so many gorgeous pieces, items that I would still consider like mainline pieces that are reduced, as well as some other gorgeous outlet bits as well. So really happy that I picked both of those up. You know what I'm like. I am the epitome of, if I like it, I'll just get it in another color. And I now own, I'm looking at them over there because they're sitting over there, white, beige, green, navy blue. And then I've obviously got the black, which I'll replace with this black. 6 different colors of the Ralph Lauren jumpers. I think I need to go to Ralphie Anonymous, because that is a bit of an addiction. But I do love them and I do wear them, so I think it was a good purchase to make. We then have some gorgeous jewelry bits that I could not resist picking up. You guys know how much I adore Monica Vinader. They are one of my favorite jewelry brands, and I feel like over the last couple of years I've really had a lot more fun with my jewelry. I've been really growing my collection, adding to it, and just adding beautiful, timeless, classic pieces in there. I feel like I have so much more fun with my jewelry than I ever used to. And Monica Vinader is always one of those brands that I feel like when it comes to Christmas gifting, they are always top of the wish list. I always know so many girls that have Monica Vinader pieces on their wish list that they ask for Christmas, and I absolutely adore their pieces. And I feel like a lot of people don't actually realize they're at Bicester Village. I texted a couple of other girlfriends that I managed to pick some bits up at Bicester, and they were like, hang on a second, Monica Vinader is at Bicester Village? And I feel like a lot of people don't know, because it's on the same like strip where the White Company is. It's kind of opposite the White Company, so because it's one of the like off streets at Bicester, it's one that's maybe forgotten about a little bit. But I wasn't able to vlog in there because it was so busy. It was absolutely heaving. There were so many girls in there looking for some gorgeous jewelry bits. I saw a lot of people pointing out some things going, I'd love that for Christmas, I'd love that for Christmas. I saw boyfriends picking things up, husbands picking things up. I do absolutely adore their pieces. So I actually got a couple of bits that match, because you know me, I love a matchy moment. And the second I saw these, I just fell in love, and I don't have anything like these in my collection. So the earrings that I picked up are this beautiful kind of vintage inspired pair. Let me see if I can show them to you. I mean, how gorgeous are these? The most beautiful vintage inspired gold hoop earrings. I just fell in love with them. I feel like I don't even need to explain anymore my love affair for earrings. I feel like they just make up the building block of your outfit. They just elevate any look and are so easy, like so simple to style. I don't know if you've noticed, but I feel like I've really stripped back what I wear with regards to my jewelry. Like, I don't overwhelm myself with rings, I don't overboard my arms with bracelets. But when it comes to beautiful earrings, I feel like it just lifts your outfit and is so, so stunning. So I don't have anything like these in my collection. Just the most gorgeous little kind of tiny, very vintage inspired gold hoops. I thought these were absolutely beautiful. I loved the detailing on them. They really remind me actually of something that my mum used to wear back in the 80s. I might have to ask her if she has anything similar to this. I bet they're still sitting in her jewelry box. I'll tell her to bring them back out, because they are back on trend and I could not be more in love with them. And I may have gotten a little bit carried away when I saw that the earrings actually came with a matching bracelet. So I couldn't resist it. I couldn't walk away and not have a gorgeous little matchy set. I feel like the Monica Vinader bangles are just unlike any other. So it's a beautiful gold bangle with the same gorgeous vintage inspired detailing to it. I mean, how beautiful that looks. This literally looks like this could have come straight from my mother's jewelry collection, or even my grandmother's jewelry collection. I think it is so, so beautiful. Very Cartier inspired, but like with its own little twist. Oh my gosh, how stunning is that? It fits so, so perfectly. I feel like Monica Benedette just do bangles unlike anybody else. And when it comes to bracelets, bangles are always my favorite. So I love the fact that you can just wear these together. So simple, yet so elegant and so timeless. If you just want some gorgeous jewelry that looks like it cost about 2 extra zeros on the end of the price tag, that it actually did. They look so beautiful, so vintage inspired. I could not be more in love. I feel like that would make a great Christmas gift. Any boyfriends, husbands that are listening in the background, this is a little PSA that the links are down below. I'm sure your girlfriend, your wife, your sister, your mother is going to absolutely love these, and especially getting them a matching set, I think is just so, so special when it comes to Christmas gifting. So could not resist the little matching set from Monica Benedette. They had gorgeous pieces in at the Vista store as well. I was really, really impressed with the stock levels that they had. So would definitely recommend checking out Monica Benedette at Vista if you are making a little trip and making the most of the discounts. Moving on to the white company. I was actually quite restrained in the white company. They had so many gorgeous bits, but to tell you the honest truth, it was so busy in there. By the time we visited, I felt like I couldn't vlog an awful lot because there was just people everywhere. There was a huge queue out the door and they were making sure to get through people as quickly as possible. So I actually just picked up one thing from the white company, but it is one of my favorite scents. Obviously they had the winter scents in there, which I absolutely adore, but I felt like I couldn't really give them a proper sniff and like a proper whiff. Although mulled wine I did have last year, absolutely love it. They also have mistletoe, which I think I had last year and adored, and of course the classic winter scent. But I wanted to pick up something for when Christmas is actually over. This is Cassis. And I feel like this is such a beautiful winter, but not festive scent. It's got in it cassis, blackberry, and cedar. And I feel like it's the blackberry and cedar that mixes together to just create a beautiful wintry scent, which I absolutely adore. They had really good offers on all of the reed diffusers and a lot of the candles as well. This was 30, reduced to 20. So a whole 30% off, which I think is absolutely amazing. Would definitely recommend popping into the white company, but I think we made the mistake of going a bit too late. I think next time that should be one of your first visits because, wowee, it is popular. It was busy, but we all still managed to do a bit of damage whilst we were in there. I think Emily did the most damage. She got a lot of bits, but was so happy with her purchases. They had like dressing gowns, they had loads of towels, they had lots of like home bits as well. A great one to visit, but I was very restrained in it. Kind of proud of myself, but also kind of wish I'd made the most in there a little bit more and picked up a few other bits. Another store that I feel like is slept on a little bit at Bista is Molton Brown. It's another one that I feel like, because it's not on the main strip, a lot of people do tend to miss it. It's right on the front actually by the car park. So it's a good one actually to hit as you're like on your way home, heading back to the car. But I picked up a couple of my favorite bits from Molton Brown, starting with the Rose Dunes body wash. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I feel like a body wash is an amazing gift to get someone for Christmas because it's something that you don't often think to treat yourself to. They're obviously very luxurious, a little bit of an investment, but when I tell you, they smell absolutely incredible. I'm not joking. Rose Dunes is one of my favorite scents at Molton Brown. Alex and I are big Molton Brown fans. We absolutely adore their perfumes. I love their moisturizers. I love their body washes. And I feel like actually showering with a beautiful smelling body wash makes your perfume go a little bit longer. I find that when I use this and spray my Rose Dunes perfume at the same time, I get so many more compliments on what I'm wearing, which is so funny and not something that I'd ever really considered up until now. I mean, if you really want to give that hit of fragrance, the moisturizer as well. I absolutely adore the Molton Brown moisturizer. So I picked up the Rose Dunes body wash and also picked myself up a top up of the Rose Dunes fragrance, which again, I feel like is one that is completely mainline, is one of their most popular fragrances at Molton Brown. Great one to pick up when you can. And I'm almost out of Rose Dunes at the moment. I am scraping the bottom of the barrel with my fragrance with it, and it's always one of my most complimented fragrances. I'd say with Molton Brown, their fragrances are definitely the best at lasting the longest and really standing the test of time. I will spray this in the morning and still have people complimenting me in the evening on what fragrance I am wearing, and also the aftershaves. I think Alex has 3 of the aftershaves now, and we absolutely adore them. They are just so classic, so timeless. They smell absolutely amazing, and a lot of their fragrances are quite unisex as well. So a really, really great gift to receive, a lovely one to treat someone to this Christmas And of course, I've saved the best till last, my new handbag that arrived this morning. So not a Bista purchase, but I thought we could do the unboxing together. Speaking of Bista handbags, oh my goodness, they had so many gorgeous handbags in. I would definitely say it's one of the best like stocks I've ever seen of their bags. Of course, my little Jimmy Choo, which is behind me, my bonbon, which was at Jimmy Choo in so many different like variations. They had the exact one that I have as well, the black velvet with the gold hardware. They had the sparkly ones, they had more kind of like patina ones, they had leather ones, suede ones, silk ones. Oh my goodness me, they had so many in the store, which I couldn't believe. And of course, my little Longchamp bag as well, which honestly I have never seen in the suede ever since buying it. So definitely head down to Longchamp. They have all the lapliages on the wall, which is absolutely insane to see at Bista, and obviously so many other gorgeous bags are part of their kind of mainline collection. But my new handbag is from a new brand that I discovered a couple of years ago, and I have had this brand on my wishlist for a little while now. They do the most beautiful, timeless, classic handbags, and that is Songbon. Now, I believe they come from America, so this did take a little while to come over to me. So if you are thinking Christmas gifting, definitely get it in sooner rather than later, because you don't want to have it not delivered in time for Christmas. But when I saw this bag on the website, I thought that is the perfect, like, everyday classic kind of crossbody bag that is such a gorgeous handbag to use time and time again. It's the kind of handbag that I feel like it's gonna look more beautiful the more bashed about it is. So let me show you my new baby. Okay, let's get this packaging off, because as lovely as it is to make sure that the bag arrives in beautiful condition, I feel like we can't appreciate her properly. Here she is, my beautiful new mini drippy roof bag from Songbon, which I think we can all agree is the most aptly named bag, the most fun named bag in my collection, the mini drippy roof bag. I mean, I could not be more in love with her. She's a gorgeous little crossbody bag in the most beautiful chocolate brown leather. I've gone for the grain leather, which I would always recommend going for with your handbags. I am not gonna lie to you, I'm not the most careful with my bags, and you can definitely tell with my more soft leather handbags. When I bash them about, when I use them, I'm a big believer that your bags deserve to be loved, deserve to be used. And obviously that is gonna mean you're gonna see signs of wear, because I feel like all of my grained leather handbags, you barely see any signs of wear in them. And I've been on the hunt for a beautiful crossbody handbag for such a long time. I don't really own any bags that don't even have a top handle, but I've been really wanting to get a bag that's just such an easy, like, sling-on handbag. You know when you go to the garden center, or you go to like a Sunday pub lunch, you're just like popping out quickly, and you literally just want something you can just chuck your wallet in, chuck your keys, and you don't need like a huge ordeal. You don't need to design a bag with like big logos, anything ostentatious. You just want something really high quality, really beautiful, that's going to do the job. And I feel like Songbon are the perfect like price point. They're not like designer bag price points, but they are very much in that kind of like luxury sector. They do the most beautiful handbags, which I would say are the epitome of quiet luxury, because the only place you can see the branding is actually on the side of this bag. So it says Songbon on either side, and it's got loads of little kind of like flappy bits, little like sections. I mean, this comes up, which I absolutely love. It's all magnetic as well, so really nice and secure if you're worried about like going into London or anything like that. And it's actually really roomy on the inside. It's got a beautiful suede lining on the inside. How stunning is that? And I feel like that is just the perfect size just to chuck in my camera, my keys, my phone, my wallet, and then I will be good to go. They do have a bigger version of this, which has like a top handle with it, but I just really want it to be super understated. I wanted it to be just like super classic and timeless that I can just sling on. You can also adjust the strap, so I'm probably gonna need it a little bit tighter on my very petite frame. But I just love the colorway, the chocolate brown. It's absolutely stunning. And I don't know if you can see, it's got this gorgeous like white stitching across it, which I just think is such a lovely little detail. So the perfect bag to add into my collection. I feel like this is unlike any of the other bags that I own. I feel like this is really filling a gap that was missing in my bag collection. perfection, and I know I'm going to get so much wear out of her this festive season. I feel like she's just going to be so perfect whenever I'm going to any Christmas events, like Christmas markets, festive light trails, garden center visits. She's going to be what I reach for. I mean, the chocolate brown is so, so beautiful. I can't stop feeling her. I love the grainy leather as well. She's very lightweight. Oh, she also has feet, which is very important to me. Oh, I need to take these little, oh, how cute is that? These are like rubber bits to protect the feet, but that is something really important to me. I hate putting my bags down and them getting dirty on the bottom, like the leather getting ruined. So that is such an important thing to me. So yes, a beautiful new bag to add into my collection. I could not be more obsessed with her. I could not be more in love with her. So just to show you how she actually styles up, because I feel like it's really helpful seeing it kind of on you in person. Although something just to note, to always remember, is that I am a very petite person. I'm a very small person, and often it doesn't come across on camera. I feel like it's not until you see me next to things that kind of can put it into comparison that you realize how tiny I am. It was actually my YSL Cassandra sitting behind me. It's so funny. I have the smallest version of the Cassandra, and I had so many people message me when they ordered the mini version, double checking that they had the correct one. And they were like, are you sure that you don't have like the second smallest size? Because it just looks so much tinier on me than it does on most people, because I am such a tiny person. So this is, I would say, like just over iPhone size. You can just about fit your phone. I can fit my camera, my wallet, the perfect kind of crossbody bag, the perfect mini bag for me. But obviously, as I said, they do have a slightly bigger version. But what I love about this is I've actually not had to adjust the strap. It fits so perfect crossbody. And then you've also got kind of two bags in one with her, so you can tighten the strap and wear her as more as like a 90s shoulder bag, which I love, because then it makes it a bit more of like an evening bag. I feel like this is like daytime, super casual, going out to the shops. But if you are going for a fancy lunch, if you're going out for dinner in the evening, wear her 90s shoulder, and she looks so much more elevated, which I absolutely adore. I love the fact that she's got feet. I love the fact that she's like super easy access, but still very secure with the magnetic closure, and just such a perfect size. So I wanted to show you her on because this is exactly how I'm going to be wearing her. Casual little festive outfit, chucking her on crossbody. I could not be more in love with her. I feel like she is just the perfect addition into my handbag collection. So I'll leave a little link to Songmoon down below, because I feel like they would make such great Christmas gifts, even if it is just like a little wallet for like a little stocking filler or something very special, like a new handbag. She could not be more gorgeous. So speaking of Christmas gifting, I've just come into our bedroom, because this is actually where Alex keeps his fragrance collection. And I feel like he has quite the fragrance collection, of course, many of which are Molton Brown. He has not one, not two, but three Molton Brown fragrances. And if you are thinking about maybe treating one of the lovely men in your life, whether it's your brother, your dad, your boyfriend, your husband, I feel like a Molton Brown aftershave is just such a well-received gift, such a lovely thing to receive under the tree. So I thought I would tell you what's in Alex's collection, which ones are my absolute favorite from Molton Brown. Because one thing I will say about Molton Brown is I feel like they don't really do themselves a service with the names of their fragrances. So the first one is called Recharge Black Pepper. And I'm not going to lie to you, when I first heard what this fragrance was called, I didn't think I was going to like it at all. I thought it was going to be like really spicy and very peppery, but it's actually one of the sexiest fragrances I think I've ever smelt. Every time Alex wears this, oh, he is just irresistible to me. So I think this is a great one for like your husband or your boyfriend, because it's just such a gorgeous, like sexy man smell. It was actually the candle that introduced me to this fragrance. I had a Recharge Black Pepper candle and loved it. Alex also loved it, so I knew he would love the fragrance of it as well. So I actually got him this for Christmas last year, which, as you can see, they did this like limited edition kind of like packaging where they did this like gorgeous little kind of gold voile on it, and then I could add a little personalized note. So I just put Christmas wishes, so Alex can always remember I got him this for Christmas, and he absolutely adores this. He wears this one mostly in the evenings. I feel like it's quite a wintry scent as well, so a really, really lovely one. I feel like the candle and the re-diffuser as well would be really well received gifts. I actually feel like when it comes to maybe like home fragrance, men are often overlooked, and I do feel like men like a good candle. They like a good reed diffuser. In fact, Alex never thinks to buy himself any reed diffusers, but he always loves his office to smell nice, so always asks me for new reed diffusers and for new scents to go into his office. So either the fragrance, the candle, or the reed diffuser of this, I think, would go down a treat. And then the newest one in his collection was actually one that he stole off me. This is one of the ones that I would say is probably the most unisex from Molton Brown. This is Coastal Cypress and Sea Fennel. And I got this summer, and oh my gosh, it is such a gorgeous, lightweight, uplifting scent. I feel like this one would be a great one for like a dad or a brother. It's a bit more of like a daytime scent, I would say. A bit more summery, a little bit fresher, and a little bit more lightweight. So if you know men that they don't love like huge amounts of like, ooh, they don't love like really rich, deep fragrances, I feel like this would be a really, really lovely one. Again, I love the home fragrances of this, particularly the Rediffuser, and also the soaps, the moisturizers. Oh, they are just my favorite. So this is a lovely one that you could get any man or woman in your life. I think this is a really lovely unisex one. And as I said, one that Alex stole off me. I got it this summer, spritzed it on myself once, and he turned to me and said, we both know I'm gonna be taking that off your hands, don't we? So he has taken this one into his collection. Then lastly, the oldest one in his collection, as you can see, probably his most loved, but the one with the weirdest name, Mesmerizing Oud Accord and Gold. Now let's be honest, no man is gonna pick up a fragrance that has gold in the title and think, yes, I need that in my life. But this is another really sexy man smell. I feel like Alex usually wears this one on date night, so this to me just really, really reminds me of like dressed up tuxedo Alex. I absolutely adore it. Again, I'd say it's quite a wintry scent, a really, really lovely one to receive for Christmas, and a great one just to kind of like treat them to for a bit more of like event kind of styling. I feel like this is such a gorgeous one for date nights, for like evenings out, going out for drinks, like work Christmas parties, things like that. I absolutely adore this one. As you can see, it is definitely Alex's most used and most loved. Again, I think it would be so lovely to look into like the home fragrances of this, or even like the moisturizers, the shower gels. I feel like it's so, so lovely to receive something like this under the tree. And when I tell you that Alex has received these three fragrances very well, absolutely adores them, and really gets his use out of them, I am not joking. So I'll leave a little link to Molton Brown down below, because I mean, not one, not two, but three fragrances in his collection, I feel like that is a true testament from my fiance of how much he adores them. So I'll leave a little link to Molton Brown down below for you to check out. I feel like when it comes to gifting the men in our lives lovely Christmas gifts, nobody does it quite like Molton Brown. So I think I'm actually going to leave this vlog here, because if you can't actually tell, it is dark outside now. I'm going to blind you for a second, but I have been relying so heavily on this little light from Amazon. Sorry, put that back, because that is really, really blinding. This light has honestly been saving me this Vlogmas. It means that when it gets dark, inevitably at 3 p.m. in the afternoon, I can still carry on vlogging without the vlogs looking like that horrible like 70s orange tint, which I absolutely hate at this time of year. So super boring if you're not a content creator, but if you are, I'll also leave it linked down below, because it was just from Amazon, super affordable, but such a game changer when it comes to the vlog. So I'm going to leave this vlog here. I hope you like seeing the new in bits, what I picked up at Bicester, my new handbag, and a few little gift ideas for the lovely men in your life. Let me know if there's anything like particular that you want help with, if it's any kind of like themes with regards to Christmas gifting. I know we've already spoken a bit about stocking fillers, some gifts for men. I might do a little like kind of gift guide type thing for women. I don't really do like proper sit down gift guides, but I do a lot of gift guides over on my Like to Know, and I like to kind of just sprinkle them into the vlogs just to chat a little bit about some Christmas gift ideas, because I feel like thinking more about ideas rather than like specific items just helps get the like creative juices flowing a little bit. I feel like it just helps come up with some like lovely ideas of what to get your loved ones for Christmas. So I really hope you guys have enjoyed Vlogmas day 7. Can you believe we're already a week into Vlogmas? We've still got so much exciting things coming this month. So if you haven't actually hit that subscribe button, I would love it if you hit it now, and I will see you guys tomorrow for Vlogmas day 8. Good night.